give it to them. Give it to them. Suku Shaka.
So I'm fully parked, ready to head on out. Just waiting for my taxi to get here now. I'm a bit worried because of the weather, the snow. I really hope the flight doesn't get cancelled. Like, seriously, I really need to leave now. My flight has been delayed by 3 days already because I had to move my ticket. So now I'm just like so anxious. I just need to get myself to Lagos. But yeah, alrighty, and yeah, going soon.
I think it's a bit icy, I would say. It's just not formed enough to be proper snow. My goodness. Oh, level one.
Yes.
Jeez. Can't wait to be out of here, seriously. I'm finally here. Now I just need to go and check in and hope my oopsie daisy. And really hope my flight hasn't been cancelled whatsoever. So yeah, I'm gonna turn. Hello guys, so I'm just gonna give you guys a quick recap of my day so far. I'm currently at Casablanca, which is where I get my connecting flight to Lagos. So basically, I left London from Gatwick Airport to the Royal Air Morocco flight plane to Casablanca, where I am now, and then I'm gonna take another Royal Air Morocco plane to Lagos finally. There's like a 2.5 hours waiting between, so right now I'm just like in an open space where the restaurant and like duty free stop is, and yeah, I'm just chilling here. I'm not really hungry. I ate a guacamole as you have seen just before my flight, and then on the flight I had a bit of food myself, so now I'm just like, nah, I'm okay with food. I'm just gonna chill for a bit, vlog. So yeah, I have a few things on the phone. So I'm gonna wait for the announcement to start. So basically, we're allowed to check in two luggages, which has to weigh 23 kg each, and then a hand luggage for 10 kg, and then you can have a handbag. So obviously, as lots of you Nigerians will know, whenever we're going home, God help us, our bags are always, always full. There's always someone who wants you to buy something for them, bring something for them. As well as you are also like buying lots of stuff for your family back home, for your friends and stuff like that. Anyway, I have lots of clothes, I haven't like worn somewhere. Lots of them were new, and a few were like, I've worn them once for like a birthday or something, so I was like, okay, whatever. I'm gonna take some of them back home and give to my sister, because she's like, oh, bring some of your old clothes for me. So yeah, so one of the 23 kg weight luggage, one of it was just full of clothes that I wanted to give away, and then the other one is full of the clothes for me that I'm gonna wear during my trip. And then the hand luggage was filled with like some of the things from my store, shopofio.com. I'm selling to some people that have like made placed orders. So yeah, basically, so I was thinking, if we wait this luggage and it's for the away, I'll have to take away some of the clothes and give it away, because I'm not, obviously not going to get rid of my clothes or the items I'm selling on my store. Anyway, I get to the airport, I find one of the, I find one of the weighing, what's it called, the scales, I put in my coin, because you have to pay that particular thing, because you could just like to make one. Anyway, I put in my, put in the £1 coin to weigh the luggage, and the first one was 27, and that was the one with my stuff. I just started laughing, I was like, ha, I'm dead, because I actually thought that was the one that was going to be lighter. Anyway, I put that aside, then I placed the other luggage, and that one was 24, and I was like, wow, interesting, because when I carried them both, I thought the other one was heavier than the other. Anyway, it turns out my one is way, way 3 kg over, while the other one is just 1 point something kg over, so I'm like, okay, something's gotta give. So I opened the box of the luggage where I want to give away stuff. I started taking out some clothes. I'm like, not a really big deal to lose these clothes. Yeah, so I took some of them out, moved some things from my own box into the other one. There was some chocolates I bought, but once again, if you know Nigerians, you know that no matter how much or how expensive of a gift you give them, they always, always ask for chocolate. I'm just like, no, I'm never going to stress and buy an expensive thing this time around. I'm just going to buy tons of chocolate and just give to friends and family or whatever. So one of the packages of the chocolate was quite heavy. I was like, nah, this is coming out of this luggage. So I put it in my backpack. And then so I moved things around and stuff. And I was like, oh, I hope my one will be sort of okay now. So I placed it again on the weighing machine. And it was 23.8, I believe. 23.8, I was like, I'm just gonna leave it and hope whoever, like, airline assistant is isn't too finicky on, like, keeping 23 on the dot. So I just left it, and then I weighed the other one, and that one was 23.4. So I was like, okay, cool, I'm gonna leave it now. Looking around, what was left was just some of the clothes, so I was like, okay, I'm just gonna have to leave the clothes. So I just dump them into one of the recycling bins because I didn't want to leave it around. So anyway, I took my stuff and went to check myself in. Again, checking myself in. I didn't weigh my hand luggage at all. I was like, whatever, man. I'm not touching that one. I go to the airline to check in. The first thing the lady wanted to weigh was my hand luggage. I'm like, this thing will definitely over. She weighs it and it was 13. And she's like, no, it has to be 10. I took one of my clutch, metal clutch bags, and two other bags I want to give away. It was still 11, she was like, no, it has to be 10. Oh my gosh. Then I took away, I took away a jewelry box and a mirror, which I was going to sell from my store. And weighed it, then it was 10.9. She was like, oh, okay, I'll let you go with this. And I was like, oh my goodness, so am I gonna really throw away this lovely? So I was just like, gosh, don't tell me I'm gonna lose this lovely clutch bag. I'm gonna lose this jewelry box and mirror I bought from my store when I was in Marrakesh earlier this year when I traveled. So I asked the lady, like, okay, do you guys have any charities to donate stuff people have to get rid of? Because I have this thing I bought, and I don't want to just throw them away. Like, you know what, actually, instead of, you know, doing that, you can get yourself one of the duty-free bags and just put it in there, because you're allowed to also have a duty-free bag. So guys, if any of you are in this sort of position where you have to get rid of stuff, just hold on to it. So I thanked her and took my boarding pass and just you know, took my other stuff away, my handbag and my backpack away. And I was thinking, you know what, I'm not going to be carrying three loose things all around. Since we allow the duty-free bag, whatever, I'm just going to go around the corner and put the stuff back into my hand luggage, which is what I did. And then, so I did that, and I was like, okay, you know what, I've checked in, I've gone through security, now it's time to just chill and have lunch. But when I looked at the time, I was like, not enough time to like really relax. I had like about 45 minutes. So I just went to like a mama and had lunch and then quickly ran off and boarded the plane. Now going through to get onto the plane was another annoying thing that I liked. So actually the flight was quite full and obviously lots of people had hand luggage, so we actually couldn't board with our hand luggage. So they had to actually check that in for us when we're about to embark. Now the annoying thing with that is I didn't have locks on my hand luggage, obviously it was going to be with me. And now they're going to check it in, it's not padlocked. I've got like expensive things in there, nice things in there, and so anyone can open it and think about it. You know all the stories of things getting missing. Anyway, I told the lady like, look, like this is not quite, you know, right or nice. Because you knew the flight was fully booked, you should have told us while we're checking in earlier on. Yeah, we should also check our hand luggage. So then I would have known to get myself a padlock. Not now, I'm just here at the last minute and you're telling me I have to use my bag. Because my laptop was in there, so I said, oh, I'll just take your laptop out. Which I did. I currently have my laptop here with me. And then I took out a book as well, and then I was like, you know what, I'm going to take out my laptop charger and my phone charger because we're in there, because those are things I know people definitely want to steal. So I took that as well. So now I'm just like carrying my laptop around with me, carrying this book in my backpack. Oh, and what happened was, before checking the hand luggage thing, they also wanted to weigh my bag, and I was like, oh shoot. So I actually took out my laptop out with the book and one other bag out after she weighed it. She went, okay, it's fine. And then I put the bag back in, but I'm obviously still with my laptop. So yeah, that's quite annoying with the airline. Like, you know your procedure, you know the plane is full, you know people are carrying hand luggage. Just let us know rather than at the last minute telling us that now we have to give away our stuff without securing it. I was like, okay, so what's going to happen if any valuables get missing? So all you're doing is just complaining and just saying, you're doing my job. I was like, this one is not that sympathetic. Like, it's your airline, your company's fault for not passing the right information. So, you're just feeling a complaint to the airline. And I'm just thinking, like, that's going to be a long process, I'm sure. Trying to secure, okay, what's the value of the crew, trying to pay you, then they probably would ask you if you have insurance anyway, which I don't. Yeah, so that's just my little rant about the annoying airline and their procedure. Because actually, when I traveled to Morocco earlier this year, on my return, they knew the flight was full. So when we were checking in, they actually told us to check in our hand luggage. So with that I knew, okay, we're checking it in and I secured my hand luggage rather than you on the last minute telling me to give it in and then there's no way for me to keep it safe. It's just really silly. Anyway, I think now I've learned my lesson. I'm always going to carry a padlock for my hand luggage and just in case I can always remember. So yeah, I'm just here now. Let me show you. I have the cafeteria, there's like a cafeteria over there. Yeah, lots of other eateries in front. There's like a duty free on the other end. And I'm just here sitting on this table. I was editing a bit of the photo shoot I did with two lovely bloggers, which you guys will see soon. I probably would put a pic of it here just to get an idea of what I'm talking about. I was editing it on the plane and the guys were sitting in the middle. I hate sitting in the middle, by the way. I love sitting by the window of the plane, but unfortunately my ticket was coming to change. I'm depressed about it, waiting for my connecting flight to Lagos. I'm so excited. Tomorrow I'm gonna get to Lagos 3 a.m. tomorrow, which is Tuesday the 12th of December. I'm off to go and see a blogger, a Nigerian blogger, the Tonye Ibani. And we're meeting at the Domino's restaurant, really close to mine. So it's just like literally a 5 minutes walk. I'm literally burning in the sweat. Seriously, if I was to relocate to Lagos, I don't know how I'm going to do it. I'm really, really hot right now. But yeah, I have to roll with the punches, eh? When I'm in London, I complain about the cold. So I should stop complaining about the heat. A nice temperate weather would be good, but I have to deal with this right now. Anyways, I'm going to stop because people are probably wondering if I'm mad or something, talking to my phone and raising it up like this. But anyways, see you guys there. Here we are. Let's see where she is. Ah! Hey. I'm vlogging.
Well,
introduce yourself.
My name is Toya Ibani.
Tonya, we just finished watching the wedding party part two. It was alright, I guess. Some parts of the storyline didn't make sense, the plot and everything, but who knows? I guess it's all about the hype with the movie. Oh, look at those studies. Oh, these are cute. What can you even put in there? I almost feel it's for babies. OOTD. Just have a simple white vest, the long trousers, brown sandals. I'm doing OOTD. And then this sparkly vest I've had for the longest time. And I'm here with Tanya.
This was really an amazing experience.
I want to meet like a lot of people that follow my page, comment and everything. And I was thinking better we want to bond in a place that is not so noisy and we can actually like enjoy something together. So I thought let me do a movie or something. Let me do a movie together. And it was really fun. I really wish I had a lot of money to do this every time. I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed meeting new people. Like all the awesome friends today, it was just too much fun.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, I'll catch you guys later and you should definitely follow her. It's Nigerian Agora. So guys, I'm done. It's
film house is actually really, really nice. I never knew there was like an IMAX film house in Ada. All I've known is about the Cuba, the cinemas,
okay,
the film. I knew there was a couple of those. Yeah, this is really cool. So my Lego to come and check out the IMAX film house. It's been like the base one. I'm going to have to come and eat here, and I'm going to have to drop one of these guests today.
Bafemi Awolowo University. I'd like you, ladies and gentlemen, to put your hands together for Professor Eyitope Ogbimbodede. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And he will be coming with our mommy, with a beautiful wife. Beautiful wife.
Yes. Give it to them. Give it to them. Shuku shaka.
Well, well. Well, well. Keep still now.
Now we're ready. Go. Come on, do it.
Yes, girl. You're not playing.
Bitch. It is hot.
Hold up.
I got this post. It is hot.
Hold up.
And I'm on my benzo to get cold. You want to defend me?
The National Theatre today. I'm just here to take some pictures for an idea I have for the cover design for my debut novel. So I'm just taking a few pictures so I can actually tell the artist what I have in mind, and it's easier to sort of illustrate what I want done for my book. So yeah, look at the palm fronds, really beautiful sunny day as usual here in Lagos. I've taken a couple of pictures from different angles, so I'm just gonna move
closer to the building itself and take some more. It's really cool atmosphere. I feel like
all the Benins,
yeah,
that is now made up of Edo State. We are from the first son of Oduduwa.
Wow.
All right. So we are we senior the Yorubas. That is why Eko is an Edo name. So we are the first people who were controlling here was the Benin Kingdom, Edo. That's the Oba of Eramiyes. They were the people who control this territory down to the Republic of Benin. Yes, we were ruling. It was Edo, it was the Benin Kingdom that controlled this. That's why you have in Lagos here. In Lagos here, we have Eko mi hunter.
Eko, yeah. What does that mean?
Eko mi hunter. Where you say I'm going to Eko, it's hunter. So it was a hunter from Benin that founded Lagos. What this place are calling Eko today. That's why you have Edumagbo, Edumota, they're all Benin names. They are not Yoruba names. Yes, Edumagbo, Edumota, they are all Benin names. No, Balogun is
Yoruba.
So what I'm telling you now is that is why, because we are the children of the first son of Oba Oduduwa. So we are Bieri Omonoba, the son of Oba, this is our title. Because we are the sons of the Oba. So everyone is born as an Edo, whether a prince or a princess.
Woo! I'm a prince!
Yeah, prince.
Princess.
So now, you know, politically, they just gave us who we are. They have separated some of our brothers are in a Delta State, like Wari. Wari, it is we, it is Edo that is crowning Wari. Even Onitsha is from Edo State.
Oh, Onitsha State.
Yeah. Well, people say, when you get there, what did the Oba say? Oh, Oba is angry. Oba is Ibinu. So they were now calling it Ibinu. The real name of Benin is Ibinu.
Oh.
It was the Europeans that came that changed it to Benin. Now, for instance, when people were passing, say, Ibinu, the village of Ibinu, nobody actually know Yoruba were Ibinu, Ibinu. So when a European came, he said, where is it? He said, Ibinu. Every Benin. So that's how Benin is not the foundational name of Benin is Ibinu.
So before they called it Ibinu, what was it called before?
There was no. It was on the bush. He just went to settle there.
Okay.
So when he was going back, when Oduduwa was going back to his palace, he left his old son because he had built a village, a settlement there.
Yeah.
He has built a settlement already.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying? Just like the hunter came here. He came from Edo State, from Benin to hurt this area.
Okay.
He now settled. Today is not Eko. It's not spread.
Yeah.
So it was a settlement.
Okay.
So now because people were already settled, become a village,
yeah,
they didn't want to close up the village. And that's okay. My son, you stay behind, rule these people while I go back to Ife.
Okay.
So he now went to Ife. So the first son now was the one who gave birth to all the Edos.
Okay.
We don't give our birth right to anybody.
Mm.
We are priests. We are princesses. We don't give our time to anybody.
Now I've been to town, I've been to the pool.
fish man for the food. If you're ever in Festac Town, Lagos, you need to come to the native place and get yourself food swallows. Like, seriously, I wish I had known about this place since I've been around. I definitely would have come. Guys, so this is my last night in Festac. Last night in Lagos, last night in Nigeria. Just going to Domino's to get myself ice cream.
It's too much.
Should I lean forward or backwards?
I'm leaning for into high, but yes. If you, yes, if your head can touch, yes.
Perfect. Why is this cockroach girl laughing?
Guys, it's all over. Heading back to London. Holiday is over. People are fucking ridiculous. They changed the gates to the flight and they didn't announce it. So I've been sitting on the wrong gate. If not for some people who just came in and then a cleaning lady told them, I would have totally missed my flight. Ridiculous.